introducing from Tampa, Florida, Dick Slater.
Superstation. This is World Championship Wrestling, and the Stinger must high-five his throngs of fans before he enters the ring. His priorities are in the right place.
There is more people on top of that rail than there has been in the arena here all night. I think they let in some of them from the parking lot just to come and see Sting.
Bell has sounded, our main event. Out of the clear blue, Dick Slater arrives on the scene last week. He challenges Sting. Sting, of course, accepted it, obviously. And here we are, 1 week later in this big main event. This is one fall or television time remaining. Everybody's looking at their watches now. They go off the air at, you know, at 8:05, so they have got some time to wrestle.
They've got some time to go, and Sting is standing his ground. He's been in the middle of the ring for the past few seconds, and Slater is going to have to go to him. He made the challenge. He's got to go towards Sting.
Sting still fighting with a great mitter to determine the television championship. It's still in limbo here in the NWA. Double leg pick up by Dick Slater, kick out by the Stinger. And Slater will no doubt try to keep Sting off balance. The charismatic youngster from Southern California, Sting, only 3 years in the sport, but he has already blossomed into a superstar.
He's a comet. He's a comet in professional wrestling. And a lot of people say, Sting's after the TV title. He's after Muta. Why would he accept a challenge from Dick Slater? Well, Slater, a guy of his stature, coming out on national television, making a challenge to you, you've got to accept it. You can't have tunnel vision in professional wrestling. Even though his priority is the TV title, he couldn't back down from a man the stature in professional wrestling of Dick Slater.
I've seen Slater in some bloody brawls in the Mid-South area specifically. That was when I first met him personally, but I had heard about him long before that. He's always had a reputation of having one of the most deadly right hands in the sport. It's been broken several times. He keeps it heavily taped, but it is a weapon.
Slater's got a reputation as a tough guy, but as you can see, Sting's no slouch himself. Now the question is, Slater's reputation was made by brawling, by blood and guts, by street fighting. Sting, thus far, 3 years in the sport, has evolved into an excellent scientific wrestler. He's a great flyer, and he's got guts. But can he fight down and dirty with Dick Slater toe-to-toe? We may have to find that out.
I'm sure Slater's going to test his whole car before this one's all said and done. Slater likes to brawl and frustrate his opponents. Going downstairs with that solid right hand, as we mentioned. Snap marrying a Sting back to the center of the canvas. Stomps him in the face with a flat of the foot. And that's legal, by the way.
The flat of the foot, and that's not pretty, but that's the way Dick Slater is. He'll take every shortcut, and he's been around long enough to know exactly what to do.
Fans, while we have this opportunity, don't forget, tomorrow night in New Haven, Connecticut at the Coliseum. Also this Thursday night, the NWA in Shreveport. Coming soon to Odessa, Texas and Fayetteville. And right there, Slater up on the top rope. And Sting slams him down thunderously to the center of the ring. High-risk maneuver is uncharacteristic from Slater, who's basically a very methodical athlete.
Well, Slater went away from his characteristics and away from the guidelines he usually sets for himself, but in that case, it didn't work. If he goes up in the air, if he tries to get fancy, Sting's a fancy guy. He needs to go and stick his thumb in Sting's eyes, what he needs to do, because that's Dick Slater. That's the way he fights. That's the way he wrestles.
Slater makes his way back to the ring. Sting standing his ground, collar and elbow tie up. Sting with the advantage here. Side headlock in a vertical position. He's got it powered in there. Interesting position of his hands in the headlock there.
Well, you see, I think that's so that if Slater tries to break it, Sting won't suffer a finger injury. I can't see. Maybe he has a couple of his fingers taped. Maybe Sting does have an injured finger, didn't want to interlock the fingers in the common position, chose instead to take a grip on the wrist.
Gary Hart, the man with the glistening head, certainly very stoic thus far in this contest.
Well, if TBS ever remakes the Munsters as the Munsters today, I know they're going to have to cast Gary in the part of the beloved Uncle Fester. But, you know, Gary Hart, interesting point. I was going to bring it up. Gary Hart manages the great Muta. Gary Hart is affiliated with Terry Funk. Could it be a plot to stop the Clash of Champions match on September the 12th. Flair and Sting against Funk and Muta. It's a long-awaited tag team confrontation, but now Gary Hart throws Dick Slater as a monkey wrench into the plans. I just don't understand, unless Gary Hart has something up his sleeve, what the significance of Slater coming in here now is.
Our camera shot taking you right inside the ring. Great camera shot. Look at the knee of Slater. The right knee buries into the small of the back of the Stinger. And Slater follows it up with a big right hand, big forearm, actually, and a snapmare. Or is it going to be a snapmare? No, it's not. Sting's got a reverse.
There you see the science, the edge in science goes to Sting. He knows exactly what he's doing. Those 3 years have taught him a lot because he's been facing the top competition of professional wrestling. But
neckbreaker by Dick Slater. That is a veteran move to counter that particular predicament.
I hate to be corny, but since I am, there's no substitute for experience in some cases. And now that's vintage Dick Slater right there. Gary Hart, there is a reason. There is a reason behind Dick Slater coming to the NWA and challenging Sting, and I am saying it's because of the Clash September the 12th. That tag team match, he doesn't want it to come off. Gary Hart doesn't, and he's going to try to use Dick Slater to stop it.
Sting back up on the apron, but Slater takes advantage here with those right hands. When he gets in trouble, when he wants to turn the corner, more often than not, he goes for that right hand.
Well, as you can see, and you see on the close-ups, there you see it, a good shot. Slater's hand is heavily taped, and like you mentioned, it's been broken quite a bit. Slater's been in a few fights that didn't take place in a wrestling ring. Sometimes he's punched a bottle instead of a face.
One of his biggest battles was in Tampa with the late John Matusak.
I've heard the stories about that one, and I understand, and Matusak never admitted it, I don't think, but a lot of eyewitnesses say that Slater didn't even break a sweat.
And Matusak was bedridden after that for a while. He was, Slater's a very dangerous man, in or out of the ring, and unpredictable. Standing vertical suplex. And Slater measures him, drops the knee viciously right to the chest. And now back on top of the lateral press, most of his weight right on top of the shoulders, but he couldn't hold him up or hold him down.
Well, he could have held him up if he had a gun, and that may be what he needs to get Sting to quit, because the guy is not going to quit. Sting is not. But the question is, Dick Slater hadn't got as dirty as we've seen him in the past. He's putting pressure on Sting now. How far will he go? What will he resort to? And what will Sting be able to withstand in this match? That's what we're going to have to find out.
Front face lock by Dick Slater, and now he is controlling the tempo. He is dictating the offense to Sting. Sting has either got to wait for Slater to make a mistake or create a break of his own.
And Sting has been remarkably fortunate in the past in being able to find those, capitalize on those mistakes. And there you see right now, creating a break. Exactly what you said. Sends Slater out.
High risk right there. He modified the Stinger splash by putting that knee. He was going to go for the high knee. That's not a normal move for him. And Slater moved out of the way in any event. And now Sting is in trouble. Gut-wrench suplex by Dick Slater. Again, he measures Sting for another high-impact move, using his head as a battering ram. Crawls on top for the lateral press. 1-2. I started to say we'd have an upset here, but really, with Dick Slater's background and credentials, would it really be an upset? I think not, once you really analyze both men's background.
I think Dick Slater has been away from national television, been away from the NWA for long enough that some fans may not be familiar with him, but for the ones that are, it wouldn't be considered an upset, because Dick Slater is a top name in wrestling. You mentioned Sting would have to create a break. The knee into the corner was not a normal move for him. He was trying to ad-lib something on the spur of the moment to create that advantage that he needed. Unfortunately, Slater was just too quick for him in that instance. But as you say, Sting's coming back up to a vertical base. And brother, his bases can get pretty vertical and pretty base when he goes after it.
He's using his right hand, much like Dick Slater did earlier. Atomic drop. Slater right outside from that momentum, like he was recoiled out there. And now Sting follows him out. He's in Slater's domain. To the steel ring post.
He didn't need to do that. He's in Slater's domain, just exactly what you said. He shouldn't have taken it outside. He had Slater on the floor. He should have taken a breather inside, made Slater come to him. He went out and he played in the cat sandbox, and that's what happened.
Sting now will have to reach down. We have said it many times. Momentum has changed to Slater's corner of the ring. gut check time for the man from Venice Beach, California, as Dick Slater from Tampa, Florida, continues to work on this outstanding youngster. And the sleep hold, coupled with a fatigue factor, this may be too much for Singh to overcome.
And there's not a lot of wrestlers right now, Jim, in the NWA using the sleeper. I think that means that Singh is ill-prepared. Well, okay, I'm even wrong sometimes. I was going to say Singh may be ill-prepared to defend against it because he hasn't had it applied to him often, but he knew the counter. The standard counter, run your man right straight off of you, use his weight as momentum against him.
Singh now fights back. I tell you, he's got that great fighting spirit. He's formed a bond led by Nature Boy Ric Flair that includes Sly and Brian. Now, those three guys, like the three great individuals, they love life. They live it to its fullest, but they live it the right way. And right here, Singh has got to continue to believe that he can win this match, to believe that he's got enough to overcome the veteran Dick Slater.
And I believe that he does believe that, Jim, because he is now he's waiting for Dick Slater to come back to him. He's using a wrestling hold rather than... He is staying with his specialty, and that's what he has to do to win this match.
Oh, real close there. Real close there in a pinning predicament. Slater just got that shoulder up. We talked earlier tonight about the mental toughness of the Cuban assassin. Dick Slater gives a new meaning to the word mental toughness.
Well, he's not scared of much, but he is scared of would scare the daylights out of most other people, I guarantee you that. And Sting right now, flat on his back, seeing a guy just like Flying Brian, like you said, with the personal endorsement of the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and that is an unusual hold to be seen used against a friend of the Nature Boy.
Certainly is. Maybe this is a subliminal message back to Flair that you're not the only one, Nature Boy, that can use the figure four, but no one can use it as well as the world champion.
That's true, and you hear the crowd now, the crowd, like we mentioned with Flying Brian, the support, egging Sting on, urging him not to quit, urging him to give his utmost. That's exactly what he's doing. Somewhere or another, he escaped that figure four. I think he reversed and rolled the weight over and injured Slater's knee.
And right now, Sting waits in the ring, Slater at the disadvantage because the count is working against him.
You know, talking about subliminal, Gary Hart with the subliminal head, you've got to think that he's trying to send a message out to Ric Flair as well as Sting. Going back to that tag team match last September 12th, I've got to think there's something on Gary Hart's mind. Besides no hair.
Yeah, big right hand and no dander.
Over the top! Oh, my God! Oh, no!
He went all the way over the top.
Oh, no!
Slater's head.
Slater is down flat on his face. Stinger, he grabbed his leg, grabbing at the knee on the way out. They both hit hard. Sting took the highest risk move of all. And they're back on their feet. I can't believe it.
Can't believe it either. Right hand. He has hurt his leg. The runner.
Wait a minute.
It's a smooth bump. Oh, no. Oh, no.
I knew it.
The control. be a broken arm for Dick Slater. Slater hit him three times with Funk's branding iron. I have never witnessed a brutality right here. Slater finally made his way back to the ring against his rival, Terry Funk. He sees the branding iron, and right here he takes the steal. He nails Slater, and Slater, to his credit, will not back up. Slater does not back up, and Flair hammers him one. And he hammers him two times with a steal. And the third time, that's got to snap it. That's got to broke the arm. Fans, we'll be right back. Don't go away. We're right back. Quite obviously, that was the plan you were talking about earlier in the night.
Maybe it was, maybe it wasn't, but if you don't succeed the first time, try again. And that's what we're prepared to do, Flair and Sting, is keep trying, make as many beachheads as it takes, because sooner or later, it will work. We had you down, but you got off easy this time. Hey,
wait a minute, Gary, come back here, Gary.
Don't worry about it, the man is hurt bad. Did you see what he did to him?
Well, you're branding iron.
Did you see what he did to him?
Yes.
That was uncalled for. It was unsportsmanlike and everything. And he's hurt bad.
Well, I don't know what he knows about sportsmanship anyway. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I tell you, I don't know how much time we have left here. But no doubt, as Funk goes up in the crowd, there's got to be a broken arm. And I'm sure the paramedics are back there now with Dick Slater. We'll have a report on that tomorrow night on the NWA main event right here on Superstation TBS. But it looks like it's all boiling down to the Clash of Champions 8, Tuesday night, September the 12th, 8:05 Eastern Time, live, prime time, and free here on TBS, the Superstation. Mark that date on your calendar because that's when it's going to be. Flair and Sting, Funk and Muda, finally, in that tag team event. We'll talk more about it tomorrow night on the main event. And remember, next week, right here on the Superstation, join us for the Power Hour Friday night, and we'll see you next Saturday night for World Championship Wrestling.
World Championship Wrestling was brought to you by Western Union. Western Union, the fastest way to send money.